Yate Arnold's YouTube day Danihinatlagi. Good evening. In today's video, we're going to learn how to say put on your mask in the Navajo language. Although this phrase seems very simple, this will be a good example of how something simple in English is actually pretty complex to say in the Navajo language. We're going to do this video in reverse. First, I'm going to give you the four different verbs for how to say put on your mask. After that, I'm going to follow it with the ways you can say mask in Navajo. Then at the end, I'm going to give you the final phrasing of how you can say put on your mask. This video will be a really good example of the difference between transitive and intransitive verbs as well. The easiest way you can say put on your mask is namaskanle, namaskanle, put on your mask. So the word ne means you. So attaching ne to mask means your mask. And the word unle means you make it. Though technically it means make your mask, it can also be thought of in the context of saying put on your mask. Namaskanle, namaskanle, put on your mask. If I'm putting on my mask, I would say shemask ashle, shemask ashle. I'm putting on my mask. If my brother Travis was putting on his mask, I would say Travis bemask ile, Travis bemask ile. Travis is putting on his mask. So you can use this exact same verb to tell someone to put on different articles of clothing, and here are some examples. Again, keep in mind you can replace the English noun with the Navajo noun and the sentence will still make sense. Necha anle, necha anle, neetso anle, neetso anle, neetnatso di anle, neetnatso di anle, neetnatso di anle, neetnatso di anle, neziz anle, neziz anle, nedeje e anle, nedeje e anle, Nitlaja e anle, Nitlaja e anle, Nitlaja e yaje anle, Nitlaja e yaje anle, Nitla kash anle, Nitla kash anle, Nistle anle, Nistle anle, Nikhe anle, Nikhe anle. You can even use the verb anle to say put on your seatbelt. Nisipel anle. Nesipa anle, or if you want to say it all in Navajo, achasis anle, achasis anle, put on your seatbelt. Now keep in mind, context is very important for these particular verbs. For example, if you were saying nedeje e anle, or saying nedlakhal anle, it can also be taken as make yourself a shirt or make yourself a skirt. So context is very important. But some of the commands, like nichahanle, clearly mean put on your hat. Nichahanle. Now, another way you can say put on a mask is to use a verb that means to cover it, like you're covering something with a cloth-like item. We will begin our discussion by talking about the transitive verb first, begeltke. Then after that, we're going to talk about the intransitive form, begeltke. Begeltke. These are both nouns that you say to cover it, but you're meaning with a cloth-like item. For now, in our examples, we're going to use the word hani, face. It's a little more complex than this when you're saying put on a mask, and we'll talk about that later, but initially we'll start using the example hani, meaning your face or one's face, hani. For our transitive verbs examples, we're also going to be using the English word mask. Later on, we'll say how you can say the word mask in Navajo, but for now, we're going to use the English word mask, so at least you can see how the sentences are structured. If we introduce the noun now, it'll make the sentence too complicated. So for simplicity, we're just going to use the English word mask, and then we'll talk about the noun mask in Navajo later on. To say cover your face with a mask in Navajo, you would say nini mas bikintke. Nini mas begintke. Cover your face with a mask. Nini mask begintke. If I'm covering my face with a mask, I would say Shini mask begeshtke. Shini mask begeshtke. If I'm saying Tyreek is covering his face with a mask, I would say Tyreek bini mask yegiltke. Tyreek bini mask yegiltke. Tyreek is covering his face with a mask. Tyreek bini mask yegiltke. Using a word like begeshtke, begintke, yegiltke. These are all verbs saying that you're covering something with a cloth-like item. You can use it in other examples, such as Baka dahastahe beltle bikiniltke. Baka dahastahe beltle bikiniltke. Baka adane naatahe bikiniltke. Baka adane naatahe bikiniltke. Awe beltle bikiniltke. Awe beltle bikiniltke. Now keep in mind, when you're saying Awe beltle bikiniltke, you're saying cover the baby with a blanket. You're not saying wrap the baby with a blanket. You would say Awe beltle bithidis. Awe beltle bithidis. That means wrap the baby in a blanket. Now to say tablecloth in Navajo, you would say Baka adana bikiniltke. Baka adana bikiniltke. If you were to say Baka adana bikiniltke bikiniltke, it would sound wordy and repetitive. So the easiest way to shorten a sentence like that is to use the intransitive verb bikiniltke. Bikiniltke. So bikiniltke means you cover it, but because it is an intransitive verb, you don't say what you're covering it with, you're just saying cover it. So to use the intransitive verb to say put on your mask, you can say Nini bikiniltke. Nini bikiniltke. Cover your face, Nini bikiniltke. You're not using the noun mask at all, you're just saying cover your face. If I was putting on my mask, using the intransitive verb, I would say Shini bikiniltke. Shini bikiniltke. Now if I was saying Tanya was putting on her mask, I would say Tanya bini bikiniltke. Tanya bini bikiniltke. Tanya is putting on her mask. Now here are some examples of how you can use this verb to tell somebody to cover it. Again, I'm presenting it with Navajo nouns. Feel free to stick in the English nouns and it'll still sound correct. Baka adana bikiniltke. Baka adana bikiniltke. Tseske bikiniltke. Tseske bikiniltke. Awe bikiniltke. Awe bikiniltke. Now for fun, let's compare the transitive and intransitive verbs. For those of you who are studying Navajo verbs, the glottal stop for the transitive verb will appear in the object prefix position, bikiniltke. Now, for some of you who are not studying these verbs and you don't know what that terminology means, don't sweat it. But for those of you that do, just keep in mind that the glottal stop appears in the object prefix position. If you wanted to tell someone to close the curtains, you wouldn't say window, curtain, bikiniltke. If you're doing that same bikiniltke, you're telling somebody to physically cover the window with a sheet or with a curtain. When you're telling somebody to close the curtains, what you actually say is window, curtain, bedadinilbal. Window, curtain, bedadinilbal. And that leads us to our next way of how you can say put on your mask. Nini mask, bedadinilbal. Nini mask, bedadinilbal. Basically, kind of like you're using a curtain, it just means that you're covering an opening, which is your mouth, with a cloth-like item. Nini mask, bedadinilbal. If I'm putting on my mask, I would say Shini mask, bedadinilbal. Shini mask, but that didn't spot. Now, if I was saying Tariq is putting on his mask, I would say Tariq bini mask yaday de spot. Tariq bini mask yaday de spot. Tariq is putting on his mask. Now, here are some more examples of how I can use the word bedadnilbal when you're telling somebody to close that entryway or opening with a curtain. Yaha atinagi bedle bedadnilbal. Yaha atinagi bedle bedadnilbal. Tseson bedandilbale bedadnilbal. Tseson bedandil basle bedadnil bal. Chiyam bih nat nille nat ahe bedadnil bal. Chiyam bih nat nille nat ahe bedadnil bal. Now, if you were setting up curtains for an event and you wanted somebody to put up curtains on both sides of the room to decorate it, you can say it like this. Kone altsanche nat ahe daljinagi dadadnil bal. Kone altsanche naat ahadal jinagi dadadnil bal. In one of the examples we just used, tseson bedandil bale bedadnil bal, it's beginning to sound a little wordy again. Most of the time people will use the intransitive verb when they're talking about closing an entryway. So the intransitive verb for saying close it for like a curtain-like object is dadadnilbal. Dadadnilbal. Now comparing this to the transitive verb bedadnilbal, the difference here is that there's going to be a glottal stop again in the object prefix position if you're looking or comparing both of the words side by side. That's a good indicator that you're dealing with an intransitive verb. So to say close the curtain in Navajo, all you say in Navajo is tseson dadadnilbal. Tseson dadadnilbal. Again, since it's the intransitive verb, you don't even mention the curtain at all. All you have to say is close it, meaning the covering over the window. Tseson dadadnilbal. To say put on your mask using this, you can just say nani dadadnilbal. Nani dadadnilbal. And it describes covering your facial area with a sheet-like object. Nani dadadnilbal. If I'm putting on my mask, I would say shini dadadnishbal. Shini dadadnishbal. If I was saying my brother Travis is putting on his mask, I would say Travis bini dadadnishbal. Travis bini dadadnishbal. And the reason that I'm bringing up this verb in particular is because this is the verb that is used most common on KTNN when they say wear your mask.
CDC guidelines.
Again, you can use this word dadadnilbal to tell somebody to close these things. Chetin dadadnilbal. Chetin dadadnilbal. Tseson dadadnilbal. Tseson dadadnilbal. Chiyan bih nat nille dadadnilbal. Chiyan bih nat nille dadadnilbal. Continuing on, the last way you can say put on your mask is mask nini ba ninta. Mask nini ba ninta. Ba means on it. Ninta means you're putting something solid over it. Mask nini ba ninta. If I'm putting on my mask, I would say mask shini ba ninish ah. Mask shini ba ninish ah. I'm putting on my mask. Now, if I was saying that Tariq is putting on his mask, I would say Tariq mask bini ya niit ah. Tariq mask bini ya niit ah. Tariq is putting on his mask. Just like I was saying, ba means on it, you can say atta as well, meaning on yourself, atta. So you can just say, namask atta nint'a. Namask atta ninta, put on your mask, meaning put the mask on yourself. Now you can also use this verb atta ninta to say put on certain types of clothing as well. For example, nicha atta ninta, nicha atta ninta, nitlaje e atta ninta, nitlaje e atta ninta, nitlaje e yaje atta ninta. Nitlaje e yaje atta ninta. Not with kithle atta ninta. Not with kithle atta ninta. Now you can't use this verb for saying put it on for all articles of clothing. The verb will change based on the shape and type of clothing it is. For example, for jackets, shirts, and sweaters, you say bihnina, bihnina. For shoes and socks, you say bihnes. Bihne'es means step into it. People will also say bihne'es for pants and underwear as well. For glasses and gloves, you say atta ninnil, atta ninnil. For a bracelet, you can say atta ninti if it's a solid bracelet, atta ninti. If it is a loose or beaded bracelet, you say atta nintle, atta nintle. Bahninta is a transitive verb. If you want to use the intransitive form, you would say ba ninna'a, ba ninna'a. If you are studying Navajo verbs, keep in mind that the glottal stop again appears in the object prefix position. Ba ninna'a, ba ninna'a. Some people in Navajo will say ba ninna'a. Some other people will say ba ninna'a. Moving on to say put on your mask in Navajo, you would say nini ba ninna'a. Nini ba ninna'a. Again, since this is the intransitive form, we don't mention the mask at all. You're just saying you're putting something over your face. Nini ba ninna'a. If I'm putting on my mask, I would say shini ba ninna'a. Shini ba ninna'a. I'm putting on my mask. If my sister Tanya was putting on her mask, we would say Tanya bini ya ni'a. Tanya bini ya. Tanya is putting on her mask. Now, let's talk about the three ways you can say mask in Navajo. You can say Hani bikinal tkihe, Hani bikinal tkihe, or you can say Hani bedandil bale, Hani bedandil bale, or you can say Hani bahnanat ahe, Hani bahnanat ahe. And all these ways are saying the different ways, whether it's with a cloth, whether if it's like a curtain, or if it's like a solid object. Now the next complication is when you're saying hani, you're describing something that covers the entire face when you say hani bikinal tkehe, or when you say hani bedandil bale, or hani bahnanat aha, you're describing something that covers the whole face. For that reason, when you're talking about a COVID mask for protection, some people will be specific to the area being covered. So they will say, Haze do hachi bikinal tkehe, or Haze do hachi bedandil bale, or Haze do hachi bahnanat ahe. So for that reason, just saying the noun mask, sometimes you have to be very specific to what part of the face is being covered. For that reason, you can say hani bahnanat aha for something that'll cover the whole face, like a hockey mask or a face shield. And then the verb will change all over again when you're saying something that'll just cover the eyes, like if you were a superhero.
Meow.
So to conclude, the best way to say put on your mask, if you're using a mask for COVID protection or for protection from an infection, all you're going to say is Nize do nichi bikeltke, or Nize do nichi datit nilbal, or Nize do nichi ba nina'a. Those are the three ways you're going to say put on your mask. And if it's hard to remember those, go with the easiest form and just say namask anle. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to ask your parents, your grandparents, your Navajo language teacher, or leave it in the comments below. And I just want you guys to all have a nice day. Can't
Bop, 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 got bass.